you speak into the mics?
Hello, 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 hello.
Brilliant. And George, if you could.
Hello, 1, 2, 1, 2.
Brilliant. Hello, hello. Excellent. Okay, right. I think we're there. So yes. Okay. Oh, jolly good. Right. Welcome, one and all, to Talk of the Devil. This is the Lancaster University Comedy Institute's radio panel show. I am joined today by George Collins. Please introduce yourself.
Good morning. Good afternoon.
Well, it depends. If you are the kind of person who says that afternoon begins after 12 or after 1. And I say after 12 because 12 is noon, so afternoon is after 12, I would say. And indeed, the French say après midi, after midday. So, yes. We are not here to discuss such trivial matters. We are instead here to discuss much more important things, like what I have been reading on Reddit recently. And and I'm also joined by Ryan.
Hello, 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 hello. Bonjour.
Oh, awesome. Yes. So, yes, we are here. We all three of us were at the scavenger hunt yesterday. So that was very fun. Were there any clues that you guys couldn't get?
Yes.
Oh.
One of the twin ones.
Oh, which one?
I think it was one of the trees that we didn't get.
Ah. Oh.
They got the old classic Norman in the library.
Ah. Oh.
The other one we failed.
Yes, yes. Interesting. Yes, because I suppose you've actually never been to County South.
No, I haven't.
Mm, yes.
First time for me.
Yes, 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 indeed. Gosh, were there any you couldn't get right?
Well, you know, surprisingly, with Joe, you would have thought we would have done okay on that one. We were a bit stumped with the one. What do we do at the end of summer? And he didn't get that one.
It was
the barbecuing. So we did have a few difficulties about that one, but we did manage to finally get that one. We finished a respectable third place.
Yeah,
albeit out of four, but you know, it's all right.
Oh my dear. I was with my friend Tom, and we were walking to find our final clue when we bumped into Fred and Becky, and Fred and Becky had at that point already won. They had already got all of their clues, but. Whenever our team bumped into any team, we always like made a mockery of acting super secretive, and you know, trying to you know, be all cool about it. And so that's how I acted with Fred and Becky. And I was like, "Oh, I'm not telling you where we're going. go that way, mate." And little did I know that they had already won. And Fred just was like, "Oh yeah, sure, John, sure, yes, indeed." And the nasty person that he is didn't let me know. So we are here. Are you guys ready to get into our first game?
Of course. Let's go. Let's have it.
Awesome. Right. First game is Mind the Gap. This is the fill in the blanks round. So I'm going to read out a news story. A headline, and there is going to be a blank in it, and you must guess what is in the blank. So, here it comes. Businessman asks to trade space shuttle for a blank. I'll read it again. Businessman asks to trade space shuttle for a blank.
Successful marriage.
A new marital aid.
It's quite far from that, but I see where you're going.
A cheap divorce.
No, okay, it's not that far from that. It's somewhere in the middle of those two things. Although it's not along the lines of a relationship status. It's something physical, but yes.
What's it? So he trades a spaceship for something.
A space, yes. He asks to trade a space shuttle for a blank.
So the men I know who have space shuttles, is it Musk or Mr. Virgin?
Richard Branson. I don't think it's either of those two. I think it's somebody who I'm not sure if they already have the space shuttle and are asking to have something else in exchange for it, or if they have the something else and are asking for a space shuttle in exchange for it. So I'm just looking that up now. But yes. But it's not Mr. Musk or Mr. Branston, the pickle man.
Other pickles are available.
Oh yes. Oh well, I've actually got no Wi-Fi here, so I will not be able to look it up. But that's all fine. So yes. Okay. So I'll give you a hint. It's related to the body. The thing he's asking to trade for.
Hair?
Now
hair
we're
transplant.
It's not Jeff Bezos. other Amazon CEOs are available. But we are close with hair actually. It's
a hat.
Further away, it's a biological thing.
A new eye.
But that's an interesting one. No, we're getting closer with a new eye. I suppose. It's not something that he wants for himself. I think it's something that he has, but wants to give in exchange for a space shuttle.
Kidney.
Not a kidney. It's something a bit more durable than a kidney.
Liver. Is it liver? Is it says liver?
My liver would not be very durable after this week.
I can confirm it is not George's liver. something still more durable. What parts of the body are durable?
I'm going to say teeth.
Oh, now we're getting close with teeth. We're getting very close with teeth.
Golden tooth?
No. It is not made of any metal or anything. It is made of organic material, and we are getting close with tooth.
Well, then the next step, I'd say bones.
Oh, yes. Okay, so what kind of bones?
A leg. Is he giving away his leg?
No. It's not something. It's not a part of his body. It's a part of a deceased body.
A skeleton, like a dinosaur skeleton or something like that.
No.
An artifact.
Okay, we are getting very close with skeleton. It's a part of the skeleton. It's a name of a particular bone.
Oh dear.
It's not a scientific name like femurus or something.
Okay. A skull.
It's a skull.
Ah, brilliant.
Yes. Businessman asks to trade space shuttle for skull. And I wonder if I could look up the story. but yes. I believe that is it. Which is interesting because it must be a pretty valuable skull. I think it's...
Where'd you find one of those?
Facebook
Marketplace.
Questions have to be asked.
I've been looking for a while and I haven't found one yet.
Buying a space shuttle or a skull?
A skull?
I wonder...
nothing on there.
Oh, something on Gumtree. Gosh. yes. Okay. I'm not sure I can actually open this article, but that's fine. Okay, so 1 point to Ryan for guessing that. Ryan won. So on to our next one. Blank enters VIP lounge at blank, drinks juice and eats food. I'll read it again. Blank enters VIP lounge at blank, drinks juice and eats food.
Is this something to do with those riff-raff Tory folk at conference this week because they're getting up to a rather crafty evenings I've seen.
Yeah. Well, now it is not. It is not to do with the Conservative Party conference. It is a separate venue to that. It is the first blank. It is something which shouldn't enter the thing that it is entering.
Child.
Now we're kind of along the
line. A minor, an under 18.
Yes.
It is.
An animal.
Yes.
Yes. Oh, I saw his eyes light up, and I knew I was onto something.
Yes. Yes.
Dog.
Oh, now we were closer with child. Okay. So, an animal, and we were closer
with child. Is it a kid, a donkey, or something like that?
We were closer with bush baby. So,
squirrel.
Getting a bit further away. I feel an animal. And it is a mammal.
Meerkat.
Oh, we're getting closer. It's quite a generic name for an animal.
A rabbit.
Oh, we were closer with meerkat.
Meerkat, okay.
An animal which is good at getting places that it shouldn't. It's quite a wily animal.
A rat.
Oh, no, No, we. When I say we were closer with meerkat, we were closer in terms of its size.
Right. Okay.
Yes.
Guinea pig.
No. No.
A stoat.
No.
A mink.
No. Not quite.
Otter.
Now that's a bit too big.
Sorry. I should know my mammal sizes.
Oh.
Should have revised.
Yes. Yes.
Is this animal in Europe? Is it a UK-based animal?
It is not.
It is not. Oh. Okay.
So an exotic animal, an exotic mammal.
Before I go too normal, is it Australia? Do I need to go sort of bizarrely weird?
No.
Okay.
Think maybe the African continent.
African continent.
A mammal.
A lemur.
Oh, we're really close. Really close. A very generic
monkey.
Yes, a monkey. A point for George. Yes. A monkey enters VIP lounge at blank.
The Ritz.
Hotel.
We're close. We're close with hotel. It's a place where a lot of people go. Like a lot of people
Safari
go.
Safari lodge.
No. We're sort of closer with hotel. It's quite a generic location where a lot of people go and then leave.
A bar.
Oh, no, not quite. It's a place which shouldn't have alcohol, and it's quite an important place.
Church.
Not a church.
The school PTA meeting.
Oh my gosh. Not quite. Okay, so let me think, see if I can think of a clue. Let's just say I hope this episode doesn't run away with us.
Racetrack. Sports stadium.
No.
Train.
Oh, we're closer train with carriage. Train. We're
train close. Station.
We're closer with train Bus. Station. No.
Airport.
Yes, an airport. Well done. Okay, so Ryan is now on 2 points and George on one. So yes, a monkey has entered the VIP lounge at an airport. And again, I'm afraid. I wish I could discuss this article with you guys, but I can't. So yes. But there is a video of it, which does sound very good. But yes.
Probably better than the new James Bond film, isn't it?
Oh, interesting.
Probably easier to get tickets to and watch as well.
Oh, yes.
Other UK spies are available, by the way.
Oh, yeah, Alex Ryder.
Johnny English.
Classic.
Oh, yes, interesting. I've never actually seen any Johnny English myself.
Have you not?
No, really?
The fight between Mr. Bond and Mr. English would be fantastic.
Mm.
That is a comic spoof that's got to be done.
Yes, gosh.
It'd be like Mr. Tumble versus Mr. Maker. I don't know who I'd want to win.
Fight of the ages.
Pardon?
A fight of the ages, that would be.
Yes. More than any YouTuber fighting a professional boxer.
Yes.
Oh, gosh. Yes. We'll see. Yes. Have you guys seen the new James Bond?
I have.
Ooh. And George, have you?
No.
Oh, yes. Interesting. Gosh. Wow.
I'm told I will cry, and I don't cry.
Yes, it was a good film, but yes, you probably will cry. It got quite emotional at the end. Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yes, yeah.
Wow, yeah. Gosh. We're in the unfortunate position where I really want to know why, but also I feel like giving spoilers on air would be a surefire way to get us kicked off Bail Room.
Yes.
So, yes. Anyway, right. Final headline. Man captures large blank with blank. I'll read it again. Man captures large blank with blank. What do you think the first blank might be?
Fish.
Oh, now we are close with fish.
Whale.
Oh,
shark.
Oh, we were closer, I suppose, closer with shark in a way.
Dolphin.
No.
A seal.
Oh, now I feel like shark is probably the closest in terms of the sort of the temperament of the animal.
Okay.
So, animals which
feisty.
Yes, quite feisty. Yeah.
Is it a crocodile?
Oh, alligator.
Sorry, gosh. George got it. Well done, gosh. George. Yes. Now, this headline was originally Florida man catches.
I was going to say they've got Florida man all over it.
Yes, but I removed the word Florida. So yes, Florida man captures large alligator with blank.
Welly boots.
Oh, well, no, it would have to be something a bit bigger. It's a large alligator. I don't think a welly boot is going to quite cut it.
AR-15!
Okay, he did not kill it. He just captured it. It was peaceful, and it was not a weapon. So I suppose we were closer with welly boot.
But... reusable bag for life.
Sort of closer. In a way. Good God, that would be the best bag for life ever. You would be able to, I mean, the supermarkets could like put that
it
on their bags.
It would be worth 75p.
It would. It would save your life. Gosh. It is a container of some sort, but not a bag.
Bathtub.
Similar size. A container. Yes. Something that you would put things in.
I'm trying to get in the mindset of a man from Florida.
It's difficult, yeah.
It is.
Well. Well, now, the sun is shining. There's an alligator over there. I'm out on the street. What containers do I have at my disposal to capture said alligator? Containers that...
flower pot.
Oh, again, it would have to be a massive flower pot.
Okay, maybe like one of those trough ones, John. You know, the nice ones that you might buy your grandma for Christmas. Like a nice lengthy one.
Yeah, I do see what you mean. Yes, that would be... if you ask me, that would be the only time one of those flower pots are useful. But no, it wasn't one of them. It was something you might find out on the street, a container you would find out on the street.
Was it a rubbish bin?
It was. Yes, indeed. Yes, well done. Florida man captures large alligator with rubbish bin. So, yes.
I'm sure the bin men will love that the next morning.
They wouldn't take it, would they? It's the wrong bin. Wrong bin. That's the green bin. Let's put it in the black. Yeah. And leave it there for a week.
Yeah. Yes, yes, yes. Oh, wow. Excellent. Okay. So, yes, that is that. And so my creative question to you guys now. That is the end of that round, and we have Ryan on 3 points and George on 2. At the end of that round, I am going to ask you guys a creative question before we have our song break. And my creative question to you guys is, what is the best way to capture a large alligator? So while the song plays, do be thinking of your answers. And after the song, I will ask you guys for your answers, and my favorite answer I will award a point to. However, during the song, we also have another thing to be thinking about, because there are going to be 3 songs played throughout this episode, and they are all tying in to the song game. Now, this song game is where you have to use the title of the song and the name of the artist of the songs to guess a story that has been in the news this week. So the clue could be in the title of the song, could be in the name of the artist, and there will be 3 songs with these clues, and they will all be pointing towards a story that's been in the news. And at the end of the episode, I will ask you guys what you think the story is that these songs have all been pointing to. So yeah, and the clue could be in the title, but it might not be. And it could be in the name of the artist, but it might not be. But yes, it's in one of them. So yes, so your creative question is, what is the best way of capturing a large alligator? And the song I'm going to play for you guys is the song Billboards of Fire by Carter Burwell. So yes, and I'm just going to play it on my laptop. So yes, here we go. Awesome. Right, that was Billboards on Fire by the artist Carter Burwell. So yes, so does either of you have any inkling so far as to what the news story might be? Any inkling at all?
I don't.
Not just yet.
No.
Right, jolly good. Yes, well, we will have 2 more song breaks. So so now my creative question to you guys was, what is the best way to capture a large alligator? And I'm going to go to George first. What do you think?
Well, I think at first I was thinking in my own mindset, but then I thought that's no good, because funnily enough, I've never seen an alligator, you know, on the River Trent. So I put myself into the shoes of a Florida man, cowboy boots of a Florida man, sorry, and I thought, how would I do it? So first I thought I'd put on Black Magic by Little Mix, just to get the alligator, you know, false sense of security. You'd just be there sort of bopping along. That the song does it to me, you know. Don't know what's going to happen when that song's on. And then I'd, you know, maybe dangle a pork chop in front, lure him in. Mm. And of course, as a Florida man, you're going to have a pickup truck. Lure it into the back of that, and then you've got it, surely.
Yes.
That's it. Just simple.
Good old Little Mix.
Good old Little Mix.
Oh, yes. Okay. Now, this is a classic George Collins answer, because it involves meat being used. Yes, George works on a farm and is partial to meat.
I do like meat.
Yes. Yes, indeed. What's your favourite type of meat?
Ooh, I'm a big fan of chicken because it's so versatile, but I think the king of meat is probably venison.
Oh, okay. Gosh, have you ever had venison?
I have not had venison.
Gosh, me neither. Gosh, when did you have venison?
John, you are vegetarian.
That's very true.
many a time, the old venison sausages, venison steaks, the nice, very lean, tasty meat.
Oh, right. What does lean mean as a meat?
It's not fatty.
Oh, right. Oh, I see. Okay. Gosh, which are the fatty meats again?
Well, lamb is notoriously fatty.
Oh, right, oh, okay.
Duck, quite fatty.
Oh, gosh, I've never had duck either. Have you
again,
had duck?
You are vegetarian.
I have had duck, yes.
Oh, gosh.
I have had duck.
Interesting. Gosh, yes. Well, yes, okay, yes, but I wasn't always vegetarian. yes, well, excellent. Okay, so, yes, so we've learned a lot about the types of meat available. What's the craziest meat that you've had, by the way?
Craziest meat that I've had? I think a European man on a cured meat stall once gave me some beaver.
Oh, my word.
Yeah.
Oh, my word.
Very strong, very gamey.
Oh, yes, indeed. Gosh. Well,
would you have it again?
No, because I don't think beavers are the most sustainable meat to farm.
No.
You know, yeah.
Gosh, interesting. Well, yes, well, very, very interesting. What's the most interesting type of meat that you've had, Ryan, just out of interest?
I'm not very adventurous.
Don't worry. Whatever it is, it's going to be more interesting than mine, because as George
I really don't think it will be.
If you've had a doner kebab, you don't know what you've had in that. So.
Yeah, good point, yeah. I mean, have you ever had one of those, like, rustler burger things?
Yes.
I'd probably have to say that.
Well, what's in them?
That's the mystery. Yes. Who knows?
Mystery meat.
Yes, indeed. Oh, gosh. Oh, wonderful. Well, we have learned a lot about our guests' meat experiences. So, thank you very much for that. So George has used meat to lure an alligator into a pickup truck. And Ryan, what is your creative answer?
I would stare at this alligator. I'd create an emotional bond. You know, there's something. Okay. There's a lot to be said for the human connection. Just staring deeply and creating a tie between us. You know, and then I'll slowly walk towards him. He'll come to me, and it'll just be love. Just love between me and this alligator. I'll pop him in the back seat of the car and we'll just drive home and it'll be a great day. What I would do.
Oh, I love it. Okay. Very interesting. So, yes, both of you have gone with some rather nice peaceful ways, at least.
I mean, yeah, either I assumed alive. Obviously, if it was dead, yeah.
after listening to Little Mix, is it dead? I mean, Little Mix is a band on which I have no opinion whatsoever. But yes, yes. Well, excellent. That's very nice. Okay, so we've got Ryan with the power of love and George with the power of meat. And I think the most creative is actually Ryan's answer. So yes, I'm going for that. Lovely. So as a vegetarian, I'm a little bit biased, but what are you guys going to do about it? I'm the host. So we now go into our second round, round two, the true or false round. So in this game, I am going to read out three stories, and after each one, you must guess whether it is a real story that has been in the news or if it's one that I've just made up. So, yes. So, the first one, here's the headline. 9-year-old girl begins giving paid piano lessons. After gaining a musical diploma from the Open University, 9-year-old Amelia Morgan from Chesterfield is now teaching the piano to teenagers and even some adults. Those taking her lessons are visiting her house in Chesterfield, where she lives with her parents and younger sister, and getting either a half an hour of a lesson or a full hour lesson. Some of her students come as far away from Sheffield, the nearest city. What do we think?
I really don't know. I mean, there's a very believable bit in that. The thing that really got me as believable was that she lives with her parents. There are some very musically talented 9-year-olds out there.
Mm.
There are.
The little...
yeah, but I don't know if she'd have the people skills to teach.
Mm.
Yes, that's my thinking.
Mm. I don't know if I would have the people skills to teach. So yes.
I don't like children, so.
I don't like children or adults.
So I think I'm going to say false.
Okay. What do you think, Ryan?
I'm going to make an intro. I'm going to say true. I think that is plausible that could have happened. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Why do you think that? Just a hunch?
It's a hunch, to make the show more interesting. Yeah. Yeah. But yeah, I think that could have happened. Yeah. I'm saying yes. I think that's true.
Mm, interesting. Well, yes. I mean, it is very possible. So you are locking your answers in. George is going with false. Ryan with true.
Yep.
The answer is it is false. Aww. I did make it up. So yes, but don't worry, Ryan. You are still a point ahead of George, with 4 points, while George is on 3. So yes, that is absolutely untrue. Well done, George. And so we now move on to our second story. And the headline is, Fake Rolex Watch Sells for More Than a Real One. A fake Rolex watch has sold for more than a real Rolex would have cost at an auction for fake watches in Surrey, where people also bid on fake Patek Philippe's and fake Omega watches. One auction goer, who has asked to remain anonymous, made a bid of $7,000 for the replica of a Rolex Submariner. However, a real Rolex Submariner would cost only £6,500. People have taken to Twitter to joke about this, with one person tweeting, "All that glitters is not quartz." What do you guys think?
I'm just trying to think of a reason as to why it would cost more. Is it like... been used in a movie, a TV show, or something, possibly.
Mm.
I don't know.
Some men do like fake things.
Mm-hmm.
Mm, yeah.
let that one sit.
Yep.
Maybe it's that's the quirk of it. You know, it's fake, and there's only one fake, so it's rarer than the real. Mm.
Possibly.
But then,
mm.
I mean, there are some very thick people in the world.
But this is you said it was a auction for fake stuff.
Yeah.
This is specifically fake things.
Yes.
Mm. How bizarre!
I'm gonna say false.
Right. Okay. Jolly good. Okay. What do you think, Ryan?
Well, I don't know if it's. I want to see the positive of it, but I want to say true. I think some people are crazy enough to spend that sort of money. I think, honestly, I think, I'm locking in. I'm saying true.
Okay, George, you locking in with false?
False.
Why did you go with false?
I can't see why you wouldn't buy the real, because the rare, if you go to sell it on, it's not going to hold its value, I don't think. Thinking ahead and more,
That's true, yes. Unless it became famous for being that watch that guy bought.
Mm.
Yes. Hmm. That's very true. Okay. I'm afraid to say that George once again has outsmarted me, because he is correct. That story was made up. But the two of you are now on equal footing.
Neck and neck.
The last round, the last question I have for you guys. Here's the last headline. M&M-themed restaurant called Mom's Spaghetti opens in Detroit. A new restaurant called Mom's Spaghetti has opened in M&M's hometown of Detroit. The business has existed as a pop-up shop since 2017, but only now has it gained permanent premises. M&M himself surprised fans by attending the opening ceremony and even serving a few customers. The restaurant serves only spaghetti dishes, those being spaghetti with meatballs or spaghetti sandwiches. What do you think?
Spaghetti sandwich. Carbs on carbs. I'm not a healthy man myself, but
yeah,
I don't think I'd go for that. I'm trying to pick it up, just spaghetti everywhere. The floor would look like a children's birthday party. It'd be horrendous.
Oh my gosh, that's very true.
And you just know the sort of people going there trying to sing the song as they eat it, just mouth full of spaghetti.
His palms are sweaty. His arm is sweaty.
Sauce being spat everywhere. Awesome. Medieval tuna banquet.
Oh dear. Gosh, yes, indeed. Yes. What do you think, Ryan?
You know what? It's America, so obviously, you know, it's one of those. It's sort of like, yeah, obviously, it could be possible, yeah. Mom's spaghetti. I don't know.
I'm going to go against what I've said so far. So I've had two falses, so I'm going to dish out a truth.
Okay, nice pun. Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
And you know what? I'm gonna just stick to what I've said because I have to at least get one right here. I'm also gonna go true. I think this is plausible again. Well, I thought all of them were plausible, but that's how that turned out. Yeah, true.
Okay, jolly good. Right. And you are both correct. It was indeed true. Yes. So America. I can imagine the floor of Detroit really does look like the floor of a children's birthday party at the moment. But yes. Oh gosh. So yes. Dear me. I hadn't thought of the logistics of spaghetti sandwiches. I wonder what they have on them. Like, just is it? I mean, I imagine it's tomato sauce as well as spaghetti, because otherwise a plain spaghetti sandwich sounds disgusting. But yes, yes. Oh gosh. So yes, that is my that is the end of that round. So we come on to our next song break, and we have another creative question for you, which is: if you guys were to open a themed restaurant, what would the theme be? So what would the restaurant look like and why? So be thinking about that while this next song plays. And this next song is the, again, tying into the three songs game. And the song name is Sit Down by the artist James. And I believe James is a band. But yes, rather than just one guy who... was never given a last name at the hospital. So yes, Sit Down by James. And my creative question for you is, if you were to open a themed restaurant, what would it be and why? So yes, right, here comes the song. Alrighty, that was Sit Down by our friend James. So yes, do either of you guys have an inkling?
I do.
Oh. Now, okay. What is your inkling? What do you think the story is in the area of?
It's on the down part of the emphasis of the songs you've had, I think. Something.
Okay.
Something landed. Something wasn't up.
I must
say... I don't want to say too much in case Ryan doesn't know, because I might need this precious point at the end to try and equal it.
Well, what about you, Ryan?
I've still not got a clue, to be honest.
Okay, now, I must say, you are not correct there, George.
I'm not.
It is not in that area. Yes, it is. It is in another area. However, hopefully, the next song will shed a little bit of light. But yes, we shall see. What I would say is out of the three words in the title and artist name of that last song, "Sit Down" by James, what word do we think holds the most significance in the recent news? And don't say it. Let's move on to the next round. But yes. My creative question to you guys was, if you were to open a themed restaurant, what would the theme be and why? And we're going to go to you first, Ryan.
Well, I've been having a little think about it. I've decided to go for a Titanic-themed evening. We'll split it up into three. Yeah, you know, third, second, first, you know, on, you know, how much you're willing to pay.
Yes.
But I can reveal to you now, it all ends the same way. The night. it's the menus from what the Titanic was. And then I won't spoil the fun, but I'm sure you can guess what might happen at the end. But it's not a pool party, I can assure you that.
Oh, dear me. Yes. Yes. Gosh. Oh, well, excellent. Very well done. I do like it. George, what do you think? What is your answer?
I'm going to go for a restaurant themed on the north of England. So instead of being down south serving up all this arty, tarty food that costs an arm and a leg, you'd just be serving up good, hearty, you know, pie and mash, you know, meat and vegetables, the odd casserole, gravy, things everybody loves.
Mm.
Obviously, there'd be some nice vegetarian options. Can you get vegetarian gravy, John?
I think you can, yes.
There you go, sorted.
Mm.
You can get vegetarian pies and all sorts, you know. And any meats will be locally sourced, so the eco-warriors can't come chasing me down.
Well, I finally get to taste some venison.
Yeah.
You know, it'll be nicely sourced from the hills of the north. The people will say hello as well.
Yeah.
They'll be nice, and like many of them are down south. And I think it'll be a thoroughly enjoyable, hearty evening.
Mm, yes, indeed. Gosh, and yes, and there will be a, lovely. Excellent. So, I was going to make a very political joke there, but I thought maybe I wouldn't. So. Now, oh, I don't know which I like the most. For showing such patriotism, George, I'm going to give you the point for that. So George is now on 5 points, while Ryan is on 4.
Wow!
How dare!
Yes. You've pulled ahead. That's right. You just gotta love the North. Is all you gotta do. It's hard, but but yes. We now come to our last game, and this game is not really a news-related game. It is the improv game Thunderdome. So, in this game, it's a very simple game. I will do points for this game, but what happens is two of the three of us will be locked in a battle, and that battle will be to name the most items in a certain category. For instance, if Ryan and myself are locked in battle, George will give us a category, for example, capital cities, and we will take it in turn. So I might say Caracas, and then Ryan might say
London.
Yes, and we would keep taking it in turns to name capital cities until either one of us cannot name a capital city, or one of us names a city that has already been named by one of us. So yes, that is the game. Any questions?
Nope.
Beautiful.
No, good to go.
So we will start with Ryan and me. And George, what is your category for us?
I'm going to say makes of car.
Ooh, okay. Subaru.
Volkswagen.
Volvo.
Audi.
Chrysler.
Skoda.
Chevrolet.
Hyundai.
Renault.
Fiat.
Bugatti Veyron.
Rolls Royce.
Porsche.
Ford.
Lamborghini.
Oh dear. BMW.
Well done. Ferrari.
Honda.
Was that the sound of a car?
it's the sound of my car, Richard. It's a 0.9 engine.
trying to get up the hill. Yes.
I think I lose that round. So well done, Ryan. You gain a point. Yes. Well done. Okay. So now we are going to move on to George and myself. And Ryan, if you could give us a category.
Let me have a think. Cities in England.
Oh, that's a good one. Oh, okay. Now, I assume we are going to go for the definition of cities being a town which has a cathedral in it.
We are, yes.
Yeah. Great. Okay, George.
Chelmsford, bringing it home.
Oh, there, great. So. Oh, well done. St. Albans, bringing it home to me.
London.
Oh, wow. Lancaster.
Sheffield.
Manchester.
Bath.
Liverpool.
Durham.
Birmingham.
Leeds.
York.
Hereford. Oh, York. Surely he's lost for saying York.
Oh, dear. The car round's finished now.
I think I lose that round. So well done, George. George, you do get a point for that. Okay, well done. And the last round is Ryan versus George. And what category am I going to give you guys? Chemical elements.
Oh, gosh.
George, you begin.
Hydrogen.
Sodium.
Oxygen.
Gold.
Carbon.
Silver. Oh.
Helium.
Rubidium.
I can't think. Methane.
Copper.
The methane is not an element.
Yeah.
It is a molecule.
Oh,
yes.
Oh dear.
Very, very well done, though. Well done. What prompted rubidium? Out of interest.
I've no idea. To be honest, I was just pulling out my GCSE chemistry.
Oh.
Yes.
Good for you.
So, who says it doesn't won't help you in the future?
Yeah, indeed.
Here we are.
Oh, yes. Shout out to Ryan's GCSE chemistry teacher.
Yeah.
If you're listening.
I spent too much time just winding my teacher up. I think an hour before the. Before the exam, we had a revision lesson with him, and I said, "Sir, I think your trousers are too short." And they were, and he didn't know what to say. Said, "Do you want to pass this exam?" "Would be good, sir." "Put your head down, then." "Yes, sir." Oh, loved it.
Oh,
good old Giles.
Oh.
Giles.
Mr. Giles, or was that
Mr. Jameson?
Oh, right. So you're on first name basis.
Giles Jameson.
Oh, very nice. Oh, Giles Jonas Jameson. Yes. Okay. Well, I think Ryan won that round, didn't you?
I would say so. Yeah.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. Oh my worship. You are now neck and neck with 6 points each. This is very fun. So we now go into our last song break, and during this song break, you don't have a creative question to be thinking about. Just the news story that the songs could be pointing to. And the song I'm going to play is Bring It All Back by the band S Club 7. A very fun song. I do love it. Here comes the song. Speak to you in a hot minute. All right, that was Bring It All Back by S Club 7. And so we now move on to, yes, the final part of the show where we have to guess the story. So now, I believe Ryan knows what ballpark the story is in. So yes, Ryan, please do share.
Now, I think we've already talked about it on that. I think this might be about James Bond.
It is. It is, correct. So, it is about James Bond. And now that eliminates the song Sit Down from the potential clues that we need to solve the rest of the mystery. So, the remaining songs are the songs Billboards on Fire by Carter Burwell and the song S Club 7. The song Bring It All Back by S Club 7. So, does anyone have any inkling at all?
Was a James Bond advertisement billboard sign stolen and somebody wants it brought back?
I do very much like that. You do not want Daniel Craig annoyed at you. That is very true. Mm-hmm. It is not that. But you are sort of quite warm in the words that you were looking at in that answer.
Is it to do with how many ticket sales it's done? It's broken records?
Now, we are along the right track in terms of it is a question of sort of popularity.
Is it the fact that it's brought the cinemas back? Everyone's gone back to the cinemas.
It's not. It's not, but it's more a question of George's first response about a billboard being stolen. The key word here is billboard.
Billboard now, was set alight.
No,
obvious, isn't it?
It is not. I'll give you a clue. It's not a physical billboard that we are talking about here.
Something online.
It is a billboard that exists not sort of as
is
a name
for film?
Something. It's not in the film. It's a billboard which doesn't exist and never existed. It's just the name of something.
Facebook?
Not quite. I've made it a bit hard. I do realize this now. But yes, what other billboards are there? Ooh,
oh,
Ryan.
There's the music billboards. Billie Eilish. Is that something to do with that?
You are close.
Number one. She's broken records with the tune Number One, and she's one of the youngest people to sing it as well.
You're very close. However, we've got it's something to do with James Bond and the charts.
Yep.
So now we just need the final piece of the puzzle. The song which we haven't used to solve this puzzle and to find to sort of narrow it down from there. There's a particular thing I shall say. It is to do with the band that play the final song.
Band.
What band played the final song?
Billy Eilish.
S Club 7, 007.
Yes, yes. So, James Bond on the charts. The number 7 is irrelevant here.
It's irrelevant or relevant?
It is relevant.
Oh, it is relevant.
So 7th in the charts.
I'm going to give that to you, George.
Oh,
yes,
brilliant.
Well done. The album for the soundtrack, No Time to Die, has reached number 7 in the UK album charts. And this is beating the soundtrack album for Skyfall, which reached number 36 in the UK album charts, and it beats the one for Spectre, which failed to chart, so it didn't reach the top 100. and what's more, this album, the No Time to Die soundtrack album, is the highest charting album composed by composer Hans Zimmer.
Okay.
Just an interesting little thing. So yes. Although I must say, in a way, that's not incredibly surprising, because Hans Zimmer also released the Dark Knight soundtrack, and that's sort of several minutes of. but maybe that wouldn't chart so well. But still, it's a fantastic soundtrack.
Yes.
The episode ends with George on 7 points and Ryan on 6. Very well done to both of you. Do you have any closing statements for Ryan's chemistry teacher? Who is listening, I'm sure.
Of course, yeah. I didn't win, but I've got to say thank you to them, my mum, and all the people who got me here today. So, yeah, thank you very much.
George?
I'm going to go home and sleep. The old end of Freshers Flues here. I set myself no time to die.
A real humble winner.
Too many clubs to go to.
yes. What club were you at a couple of nights ago?
I've been all over town, John.
Oh, really?
I've been to Sugar, I've been to Glow, I've been to both in one night.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Gosh, was that after the gig?
I had a quiet gig. After the gig, I had a quiet night.
Oh, right. Oh, okay. Oh, okay.
Only ended up walking up the A6 to get some freshers home safely.
Oh, yes, yes.
Yes. We won't say any more about that.
Gosh. Yes, fair enough. Lovely. So that is the end of the episode. Thank you so much for coming on. You both did really well. Goodbye.
Bye.
Oh, lovely, jubbly.
Okie dokie. Very nice. Well done, John.
Cheers. Thank you very much.
Pleasure.